into a seismic shove that gives you time for the trample to actually stack up for your stun hit as well. These guys are pretty squishy, so there is a possibility of pulling.
Just throwing it out as waste because he recognizes that if he just uses all that space early on, then his damage output is really going to be limited. So doing what he can to get a bit of farm and stay relevant, but Splice doing a good job of zoning Fox away from the wave.
Yeah, Splice is going to get the first level too. They are going to have the push, so then it kind of starts coming down to, oh, well, how well can Echo Fox actually see us under the turret? Because,
right.
You know, Splice doesn't have to opt into a fight.
True.
Right? Like, you can just sit back and just outshove these guys the whole time and say, well, how well can you farm under the turret? It's actually different than on SR. So, you know, you can see Huni missing the cannon there, and Splice is actually quite a lot ahead in the farm.
Yeah, they are.
Like, two turret shots kill a melee minion here. So you actually have to really prep a melee minion very heavily, whereas on SR, it's two turret shots.
That's a really good
one.
Point. It does change the factor.
And
it
one-shots the range minions, right? So it's like, it's totally different. Last hitting is completely different. And unless you've actually spent time on ARAM learning how to last hit, and I actually think the only person I saw do it properly at the All-Star tournament was Faker. He was just about the only guy who maintained farm when under his own turret, because most of the players just don't really understand exactly how to do it.
You recognize it right away or use the abilities you're used to, kind of second nature farming.
Oh no, Kasing, he's hitting the minions. He doesn't know.
Don't touch it. You can see Kabe said, no, don't do that. So as well, with this wave clear that they have, able to play with a lot of zoning utensils in their kit, it looks like the summoners also tell a story of, we want to play it safe. If you're going to go on, we have barrier. There's an ignite for aggression, but our abilities are that damaged. So easily filing this one out into CS could work for Splice.
Yeah, it definitely could. There is a seismic shove.
Oh, watch out. We also have not gotten a double blood yet. Only the one and then the secondary. So we're still waiting for these 2v2 bursts to happen at Rift Rivals.
Kasing has to be really careful now. So Kasing is without his flash. Kabe can hit the knockback on the engage from Alistar, but Alistar still has his ignite. Kasing has no summoners, so if they land that combo onto Kasing, he can definitely get bursted here.
There's one hit. Oh, the turret! That's definitely going to take down Adrian. First blood going down. Second one now is game advantage for Splice if they go on to either Huni or Adrian.
And the best thing about this is Splice isn't actually doing anything. Fox is just trying so hard to force a play that they're then just punishing Fox for every proactive move that they tried to make. And now with no summoner spells on Adrian, no flash on top of Huni, a good bit of chunk damage comes out from the side of Splice, and they're the ones leading in this 2v2 so far.
I honestly thought if it didn't happen right away, it would only happen at 6 with Adrian being so squishy on this small map and all the power from Kabe and Kasing. Still forcing up to the brush. They want to get that CS back as they've gotten within now about 7 or 8.
Yeah, I mean, not only did they actually dive into the turret, and you know, Adrian obviously just in range of that turret, but it's the fact that they went on to Kabe, who still had his barrier, right? So it's like they got both the summoners out of Kasing, and Kabe had both of his summoners still remaining, including that defensive barrier, and that's all he really had to trade out. So, you know, Echo Fox, you know, maybe not the right target choice, and obviously, you know, the mistake there of just getting barely in that turret range is what cost them the kill, but we'll see, because from this position, it's hard to see Echo Fox getting two kills, you know, straight up and ending this if Splice play it far back and just look to play it for push.
Oh, no, not good. Down to 102. There's the heal coming in. They took that to stay in the game, and there's the kill. EU coming up big in the 2v2.
Wow.